Hello and welcome to lesson 2 of the Articy Draft Importer for Unreal tutorial series. In the first lesson, we defined our goal for this tutorial series, which is to display branching dialog imported from Articy with a custom dialog system in our Unreal project. We took a first look at both Unreal and Articy projects, installed the Articy importer from the marketplace, and exported Articy data to Unreal. In this lesson, we will begin working on the dialog system to display a first dialog line with the speaker name in the custom dialog UI. First thing is to add a flow player component to the demo game mode blueprint. I briefly mentioned it in the first video. This will make the magic happen. It traverses through the flow, handles branching, evaluates conditions, executes instructions, and will make callbacks to our game code. There is a lot going on in the details tab, but at the moment the only entries of relevance for us are pause on and start on. Later, start on will be set dynamically. For this first test, let's select linear test as the start node. Pause on defines where the flow player will stop during flow traversal. There is no one correct answer what to select here. It depends on how your project is set up. Generally speaking, it makes sense to have the flow player stop only on elements that have data you need to fetch or that you want to display. For this project, I set pause on to dialogs and dialog fragments. Now, let's see if we can access any Articy data. To actually display text, we need to add an onPlayerPaused event in the demo game mode event graph and add functionality to it. We can create the event by either using the right-click create menu or by selecting the Articy flow player component and adding the event from the details tab. First, we cast the object we paused on to an Articy node, as we don't have any more specific information about the possible node type at this point. Then we get its type, and from there make a switch for the pausable types with switch on eArticy pausable type. If we expand this node, we can see that it contains all the options that we encountered in the pause on dropdown of the Articy flow player component earlier. As our dialog is composed out of dialog fragments in Articy Draft, we continue from the dialog fragment pin. Now we have to do another cast to be able to access the text of the node. As often in programming, we have different options. It solely depends on what you are trying to achieve and how the code is set up. We will go with one way to access the text of the current node, which should work in the majority of cases. We will do a cast to Articy object with text, which basically is the lowest common denominator when it comes to node types that can have text content. The interface for the cast comes from the event node itself. Then we get the text and print it to the output log and the screen for now. But when we hit play, nothing happens. Why is that? If we look back on our on-pause settings for the Articy flow player component, we can see that we selected dialog fragments and dialogs. Our starting object is linear test, which is a dialog node. That means the flow player starts and immediately pauses. Going back to our onPlayerPaused event in the blueprint, you will notice that nothing is set for a pause on the dialog, so we are basically stuck. Solutions would be to either remove dialogs from on pause or add an instruction in the blueprint to define what is supposed to happen when the flow player encounters a dialog node. Usually, I would lean towards only pausing on node types that include any logic that need to be processed. But to show how the situation can be handled, I will add a statement to the dialog pin of the switch. As a general rule, you should make sure that you create a pass on the switch for all node types you selected in pause on. Otherwise, you might run into issues if the flow player pauses on a specific node type, but does not have any instructions for it, as we have seen earlier when we tried to play our level. What we do is adding a command to the flow player to immediately continue playing when pausing on a dialog node. When we now hit play, the first line of the linear test dialog is displayed on screen. We are able to access and display data we imported from Articy. Nice! The next step will be an exciting one. We are going to start the dialog when interacting with an NPC, and we will display the text properly within our dialog UI. To display the text in the dialog UI instead of printing it to the console, we need to update the last part of the demo game mode event graph. We remove the print string node and use setText to display the text of the dialog fragment we pause on currently. The target for setText we get from PlayerHUD, a variable saved in creating the HUD widget in the begin play event. From PlayerHUD, we get the dialog widget, and from there, we get the dialog line. If we play at this moment, you will notice that we get a couple of runtime errors. This is because, thanks to the StartOn property, the flow player starts running right away and setText is trying to access the player HUD, which at this point might not even be instantiated. This won't be an issue much longer, because of the way our dialog system is going to be set up, once we remove the StartOn property from the flow player component. But to be absolutely sure and prevent this kind of error, we can add a simple isValid function between getText and setText and use player HUD as the input object. If your dialog UI is set up differently, you just have to make sure that certain elements are exposed as variables, so we can access and change values. Like for example the dialog line text object. If you downloaded the course material, you can take a closer look at how the widgets are constructed. Now we want to give the NPC a reference to a specific dialog, instead of having one preset dialog that starts automatically. We remove the StartOn value from the flow player component. Then we go over to the NPC blueprint and add a variable dialog of type articyref. And make it public. Now we can go to our level and select NPC 1. Choose linear test dialog as the value for the dialog variable. After doing this, we switch back to the demo game mode blueprint. Here, we add an Articy ref type input into the play dialog function. At the very end of the function, we add setStartNode Articy ref. Where we pass in the Articy ref we received as a parameter. Target is the flow player. Last but not least, in the NPC blueprint, we need to pass the Articy reference on the NPC, that means its specific dialog, to the play dialog call in the interact event. If we now play the level, we can interact with NPC 1 and see the first line of the linear test dialog displayed in the dialog UI. To complete our goals for this lesson, we still need to find a way to display the speaker name together with the first dialog line. Where do you think this needs to be implemented? It will be a second step in the on-player paused event in the demo game mode blueprint. First, we grab the text content of the node we paused on. Now we will take a very similar approach to access the speaker information as well. We add a sequence node after the switch for the dialog fragment pass. This is just for formatting to visually keep the different actions apart. Getting the text is step 0. Getting the speaker will be step 1. Again, we need to start with a cast. Analogical to earlier, this time we want to access the speaker data of the node, so we cast to Articy object with speaker. Then we get the speaker and use the result to get its display name. This we then can set as text again. Like before, we start with player HUD, going over dialog widget, but this time conclude with speaker name as the target. And same as before, we add an isValid to prevent errors in case the player HUD does not already exist. When playing, we now see the first line of dialog plus the name of the speaker displayed in the dialog UI. Great work! In this lesson, we began setting up the dialog system we are going to use in this Unreal project. We started by printing a line of text to the console log and continued from there to now being able to display the first dialog line plus the speaker name in a custom dialog UI after interacting with an NPC. In the next lesson, we will add a button to be able to traverse through the entire linear test dialog. See you there!